As well. Well, let's get a sense of the concerns and challenges that schools are facing from the Federation of Governing Bodies for South African Schools. Paul Colditz joining us via Skype this morning. Paul, a very good morning to you. I'm not sure if you've been able to hear some of these interviews or just my chat with Stefan there while you were waiting. Now, these are some of the measures that are being employed by schools, and we've seen quite a focus, especially in the past couple of weeks with recent incidents. Now, the school governing bodies, What are your thoughts on what needs to be done and what's acceptable to do at schools in order to keep pupils and teachers safe?
Well, first of all, obviously the governing body of a school has a responsibility to make sure that it has safety measures in place, that it has a safety policy for the school. As has been indicated with regard to the school in Elsie's River, metal detectors, security fences, and maybe even security personnel at the school. But the problem is not necessarily within the school. Mm. It's what happens outside the school that spills over into the school. And that is where the crux of the problem is.
Mm. And I mean, how do you, as a mixture of parents and teachers on these bodies as well, aim to, or have there been attempts in the past to engage the wider community to say, listen, we can only change so much, but you've got to do this? Have those discussions happened outside of the school fences, and how successful have they been?
Absolutely. Yes, indeed. What we did is we started with a program of what we call value-driven schools about 5 years ago, and it's been extremely successful. The essence of this program is to involve the entire community. And let me just explain for the minute the structure of schooling in South Africa. Very often schools in South Africa are referred to as state schools. They're actually not state schools. We don't have state schools in South Africa. We have public schools. Mm. In layperson's terms, that means that the school actually belongs to the public, belongs to the community in which that school is situated. So although the governing body has an important role to play, the teachers have an important role to play, it is the whole community that must accept ownership and responsibility for that school. And what we did is to encourage school governing bodies to take the lead, to get the community organizations, the police, the teachers, the parents, the learners involved in determining essential values that would apply to that particular community. Don't go into a process of just plucking certain values from the air, but engage with each other on an ongoing basis. For if it takes a year, it must take a year. Mm. Getting everybody on board, getting all people involved that may have even a remote interest in that particular school, mm. and discussing and developing a set of values for that particular school that would drive the entire schooling process, mm. the curriculum, the process of learning and teaching, behavior of everybody and every person, parents, teachers, learners, governing bodies, everybody, community organizations must then adopt those values, mm. and develop a program in terms of which those values are inculcated, mm. so that the community outside of the school, where most of these problems originate, will also be intricately involved in this whole process. It's not a quick fix, mm. we realize that. But where it has been implemented, is it has been extremely successful.
Now, Paul, I mean, we know that schools have become targets for not just pupil-on-pupil violence. I mean, what we saw happening in Fulweni in Durban earlier this week, with the teacher being shot in full sight of primary school pupils. We've seen theft, daylight robbery of schools over the past couple of months. We've seen various incidents. I mean, a school that was robbed right next to a police station. How do we battle yes. things like that? How do we deal with incidents like that where you don't see it coming?
Well, that's where the role of the community is so critically important. That would include, obviously, the police in this whole process of developing not only a value-driven school, but essentially then in the long run, a value-driven community, where the community itself will take responsibility for preventing such behavior from taking place in the community. I know it's difficult. I know it may sound very idealistic, but it has indeed worked in those communities where the school governing bodies have taken the responsibility to initiate this process and has developed it. It has worked wonderfully. But it needs every school governing body in the country to take the initiative and the responsibility to start somewhere with the implementation of such a program.
Yeah, and more and more.